Most of us know that the economy is in really bad shape, but for those of you who have been watching my channel, you know that I'm preparing for things to get even worse. And by worse, I mean it could be a situation where basic resources are not available to a lot of the public. Water, it could be ATMs, it could be anything. And essentially, I'm preparing for an emergency, whether it be man-made or a natural disaster. An emergency. So obviously the weakest part of my preparations have been the physical aspect of prepping, and it's something that I should pay a lot more attention to, and it's something that I am trying to correct by building strength. So in this video I'm going to talk about the weakness in my prepping.
Oh yeah.
Okay, by weakness, I mean areas that I can improve on, and frankly, I can improve on pretty much every area, whether it be food, whether it be water, or whether it be ammunition. I definitely need a lot more ammunition, but you know, I definitely have enough food for my family for a certain amount of months, and I definitely have enough water to last us for a while. But I need to pay more attention to the physical aspect of prepping, mainly because there was an incident last summer, the summer of 2010, where a family member was in trouble and I had to pick that person up, and I could barely pick that person up. I realized that I need to build some more muscle, some more strength, so I'm able to actually carry people. And it's something that a lot of people don't really think a lot about when it comes to prepping. We have our guns, we have the ammo. Some of us don't have enough ammo. Some of us have the guns, but not enough food. Some of us have the food, but no guns or anything to protect it. Others have the food and the guns and ammo, but they don't have the medical stuff. I'm still working on the medical supplies. I have basic first aid stuff. What I really need to acquire are antibiotics. Now, it's actually kind of difficult to actually acquire them, the ones made for humans. So I'm doing my research as to how can I legally obtain antibiotics. Now, that's definitely a challenge, because if you get a cut in an emergency situation and you don't have access to a hospital, you know, an infection could form and you could potentially die because of an infection. So it's something that's very serious. So the medical aspect of prepping is something I need to work on. Also need to work a lot more on, as I said, building the strength. Hand-to-hand combat is not something I specialize in. I don't have the money to receive professional training, so at this point I'm just gonna get used to just being a little more active, whether it be carrying my bug out bag or my emergency bag. And let me speak on that. I've talked about this before, but if you're new to the channel, my emergency bag is really for staying in. Now, the bug out bag is really something you use to organize your preps in a short period. Now, if you have to go from one location to another, it has to be a really desperate situation, because if things go bad, I'm planning on staying home. I'm not going to be hitting the road because the highways are going to be clogged up. And, you know, you're going to want to avoid a crowd. Well, I'm going to want to avoid a crowd. You guys can do whatever you want to do, but that's my plan in terms of bugging out and staying in. So I just want to make myself clear when I talk about this bag. But I still carry it around, so my back and my body is pretty much used to actually carrying that weight. And it's something that's really, really important. You want to condition yourself to be able to carry it. You don't want to find yourself in a situation where you're carrying a 50-pound bag and you're not used to carrying around a 50-pound bag. So that's very important. So I'm starting to focus more on the weak areas of my prepping. And you should see in the future more organization for me. And you'll also see knowledge-based things. I'm going to focus more on learning about different things, whether it be wild edibles in my areas or whatever. So that's what you're going to see from me. And tell me, guys, about your weaknesses in prepping, or what are you doing to strengthen your weaknesses in prepping. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.